I chose BioXcellerator. One, because they really seem to ask a lot of questions, get more into what exactly I was looking for in the initial consultations, and I just felt more comfortable. So my name is JJ Hudock, and I'm from North Carolina in the States. I heard about stem cell, quite frankly, from podcasts that I've been listening to, and I reached out to CPI. I reached out to a place in Panama, and I chose BioXcellerator, one, because they really seem to ask a lot of questions, get more into what exactly I was looking for in the initial consultations. And then I spoke to a PA, and we probably spent an hour on the phone talking about my situation, what I had going on, and I just felt more comfortable. And to be quite frank, of a place I wanted to visit, Medellin was one of the places I wanted to come back to. I had visited here before. And so that put it over the top, is the location and then the questions that were asked, the thoroughness of the pre-interviews is what kind of made me choose this place.
Now, did it live up to your expectations?
Absolutely. The staff's been great. Everybody seems to have a very, very positive attitude. The process with all the different treatments, I liked to have different ways of looking at things too, with the, I think it was the epigenetic test to talk about diet. So it's not just about the stem cells. It was about different treatments, the physical therapy, which actually was pretty demanding. Was a nice added benefit to it, as well as to say, hey, look, here's some diet things that you can do going forward, as well as some physical therapy that can help you in these exercises in these areas. So, you know, to take that with you is an added bonus with all the therapies as well.
Now, what did you get treated while you were down here?
I did my knees. Which I have arthritis in my knees. I played college basketball and wear and tear and surgeries on the knees. I did my shoulder, my left shoulder. I did my low back, my lumbar, and then I did my neck as well.
And how were the procedures?
Shockingly good, in the sense of I was expecting more pain during the procedures than I had. I had done stem cell in the States, and honestly, I found that to be a little more painful. But the stem cell in the States is very limited in the way it's done. But there was, it seemed to be more painful. Obviously, the extraction of the stem cells was very painful. I never want to go through that again. And obviously, you don't have to do that here. But the injections themselves, the knees, the shoulder was a little bit rough. That's a hard one. Makes you a little nauseous after, and it's painful. But within 2 days, everything seems to rebounded. The back and the neck, you're under, so you don't know anything. You know, literally they're talking to you 1 minute and the next minute you're out.
That's maybe the easiest procedure we have here. I've had it.
Yeah, it is. It is. And I felt very comfortable speaking with the surgeons and the doctors. That was, you know, everybody's asked me, are you nervous? And I haven't been nervous. I was nervous more so before I got here, but once I got here, I wasn't nervous anymore.
Now, last but not least, we're not talking about recovery because you just got this week.
Right.
But say if someone's on the fence and they're like, man, I want to go get this treatment, but they're like, Medellin, Colombia for a medical procedure? After going through this procedure this week and going through what you want, walking through them all, seeing Colombia, what would you tell that person right now?
Well, I've done a lot of research on Medellin. Yeah, and I've been here before. Especially staying in this area, you have zero to worry about. Zero to worry about. If you if there's any city you go to, if there's areas you go into or you're doing shady stuff, you're going to find shady results, right? But if you're sticking to the areas, even going into Provenza, and those areas that are tourist related, visiting the tourist sites, you're going to have zero problems. You know, anytime you visit a big city, you got to watch out for little things like pickpocketers. And obviously you just can't leave your phone laying around. You can't leave your stuff laying around. There's always that, but that's any big city in the world that you travel to.
Common sense.
I've felt zero, threat since I've been here. And this is my second time visiting, and I'm staying another week after this.